says.
You are facing down a hungry red dragon.
What?
It has 2 hit points remaining. You are 20, oh. You are 15 feet away from it. What do you do?
Attack it?
Okay, then make your move and charge.
Oh, has... I clicked the wrong thing. Never mind.
All right, well, you might do 6 damage, but, you know.
Okay, what do I do? I'm confused.
Meanwhile, the rest of you are just watching. No, okay.
Boris, roll at 1d20.
1d20 plus 5, right?
Plus 5, whatever your melee is.
Well, if you're going to move in and attack, yes. It's already used up attacks of opportunity to kill Hemet, I think.
Well, Snoopus is killed.
No, do I roll twice because I would attack with both weapons?
Yes, you have a slight penalty to this. It's -2 and -6, your first attack and second attack, respectively.
Okay.
Because of your reduced 2 weapon bonus.
But see them ones, get them ones out of the way now, please.
Okay, your first weapon, a heady pick, misses.
Of course.
Your second weapon.
Oof.
Also misses.
Oh no.
Let's see this hungry red dragon attack.
The hungry red dragon looks at you confused. You're far too big for... My meal has arrived.
Shadow, you know what's going to be really funny?
Dance for my amusement.
If you roll one here, you're going to be so stupid.
The dragon isn't attacking. It's asked him to dance for his amusement.
Wait, what? Wait. I wasn't paying any attention.
Dance,
you're dancing for a dragon.
I recommend dance.
I lift up my shirt and do the truffle shuffle.
Let's see it.
What? How do I
move your token and should be dancing.
I don't know how to... Oh, select mode. Okay.
I wish to,
I have to juggle.
Did I add my ghost joints in his dance?
That's the thing that, the guy from the Goonies did, right? I got...
Wait, turn order's working.
Turn order is working, but I kind of had to adjust it slightly for this. But anyway, the red dragon is partially amused by your dance. It flies off. It flies off.
Really?
I continue dancing, unaware that the dragon has left.
Make it.
I have to see Chunk do the truffle shuffle to refresh.
I may have urinated slightly.
I demand to.
That only helps the performance.
Can Boris make a a perform role from that?
Yeah, I asked him for a perform role.
You didn't do it.
I didn't hear you. No, lots of people talk.
I know this happens. Stop that.
Sorry, we're dancing his dance.
It's just a one d20.
D20 charisma bonus, I think.
It says plus 0.
Then plus 0 it is.
The truffle.
Hell yeah, maybe.
That's a really good
one. The dragon hasn't come back and burned you to death, so we'll assume you got lucky.
Woo!
In the meantime, let me find out the room we're actually still in. So, welcome to the library. When you last left off, you'd found a small little temple room inside of the monastery, where you encountered Gral Balin, a heavily wounded, unconscious wizard, and you basically had that discussion from the end of the last session.
Who's now stabilized thanks to the efforts of Matt Warwick.
And me.
And he's also kindly agreed not to rob you blind if you find the sword.
I haven't agreed to anything.
Well, that's what he agreed to, anyway.
He gave us some information, didn't he?
Yes. Deadens, if I remember right.
Well, he told us about the
only thing he said.
Yes,
really.
The corpse he found earlier was apparently their expert in matters of the undead. He was ambushed.
Not a very good expert.
Well, he was ambushed, jumped from above, aged about 30 years. And then just died shortly afterwards, only to be eaten by rats. And then for somebody to steal his cloak, boots, and whatever else he had. Mentioning no names.
Mm-mm. It was so without Boris, but...
Listen checks for everybody.
Okay.
That's a d20, right?
Yep.
Plus where he lists bonuses. Oh.
It occurs to me I should have made a macro for a listen check.
That's fine. I mean, listen spot, search are the main three you'll want at any given time.
Listen, I've got all my listen.
Listen bonus listen, if nothing 18. Else.
Listen and spot. This
zero.
Oh my god.
It's not the end of the world if you don't listen. To, if you don't hear this, in all honesty.
It's 10. I'm not terrible.
15. 15.
Snoop's ears must be feeling a bit strange.
I've just realised the OP thing that you've done, Shadow.
Oh?
You've given me combat reflexes.
Oh my god.
Yes, I did. I gave you combat reflexes because it's a good thing to have.
And I get +3, but I also have 2 weapons, so I can make 6 attacks of opportunity if they let the defences down.
Yes.
Oh my god.
No. I build reasonable characters.
Boris doesn't suck so bad, huh?
Well, he's just having really suboptimal equipment in a lot of ways, but in other ways, potentially amazing.
He's brilliant.
Right, those of you who rolled above 15, so actually,
above 15.
Yep. So Hemet Sparks is the only one to hear this. You hear some movement beyond the doors. As you hear this, Grull immediately charges towards the door and raises his heavy mace, preparing an ambush.
Alright, I'm going to join in, get my crossbow out, and go to the side of the room, I guess.
Okay.
Like, here-ish.
I assume it...
And I'm going to tell them there's noises out there.
I assume you mean this door here, Shadow.
Yes, I do. That's the only door to the room.
Balin
sneaks up behind. There are effectively benches and things there. He sneaks up behind them and draws a short sword.
I equip my hand crossbow and go behind the body, aimed at the door.
Okay.
What's going on? Why is everyone rushing at me?
Boris. Some brief background for your character and what he knows. You've been traveling through the Kalkari Wildwoods for the last 2 or 3 days now. It's not the most inhospitable forest in the world, but, you know, it's fairly passable. You have, however, encountered a large number of hobgoblin bands, almost scouts, effectively. They haven't spotted you. You've kept well out of their way, but there have been quite a lot of them. Certainly enough to suggest to you there might actually be a war camp or something in the area. Last night, you you saw various lights and flickering coming from an abandoned monastery in the corner. In fact, actually, this doesn't work on the timing threshold in any case, but don't worry about this for now. You see various lights, sparks, and you find also a few horses tied up nearby.
Where do I see this?
I'm going to go for a brief explanation of basically this is basically why you would go in there and explore it.
Okay, this about the time I blew up the door?
Yeah.
No, that was 8 hours ago, so it doesn't really fit, unfortunately. You've had a rest since then.
Okay.
Time is a bit awkward.
Oh, yeah. When we had that rest after the same fight, which been that
but, long. From your knowledge, you know that the place is believed to be haunted by malicious spirits and the undead. So it's generally somewhere you would avoid, but apparently loads of people have gone in.
I missed what place this was. Is this the place that we're in
this
right
is
now?
All you know about it is it's a haunted monastery, which is half fallen into the ocean. It's by the coast, actually.
Is this what I'm standing in right now?
Yeah, this is where you're standing right now.
Okay.
You found some tracks and have followed the most recent set. Recent set through a building. They've gone through a library where you have noticed a number of dead and squashed rats, including one oddly skewered to the ceiling.
And some
don't forget the one that's
fire.
Been stretched. One that's been stretched over a lantern to cook.
That was part of the pack, so don't worry about that too much. As you round the
rat
corner,
turkey.
You hear the sound of movement and activity from the wall to your right. Upon turning round to get to about there. You notice the door.
I've got my bow on that door.
No, you haven't. You weren't aware of what was going on. You stated this as much.
Yeah, but everyone, I moved because everyone's staring.
I would like to peek through the door. Walk up to it.
You see a bugbear with a mace about to drop it on you.
Can I make a spot check to see him peeking? just
well, you see the door opening. I don't need a spot. You don't need a spot check for that.
Yeah, can I see him, like, spot him to see if he's human, maybe?
So we're in a room and we don't see the bugbear.
And that mask would really be anything.
The bugbear in the room is Grawl. He's been in the room for a while.
The door.
Well, where's this bug thing? Is that the one that's next
Grawl
to...
Grawl is a bugbear. Giant goblinoid type creature.
Right next to Thurs.
Nice heroic.
Heroic, yeah.
Okay. May I charge through the door?
You can have a go.
Oh, no, I want to open it and then charge in. Then yeah, that's what I meant.
Fair enough, charge in!
I have an attack and opportunity on him, right?
Oh, fuck.
No, you haven't got anything prepared.
Okay, no. I did say I'd get my crossbow and aim at the door.
I run in screaming.
Right, Grawl's heavy mace narrowly misses you as you dive through the door.
Yep!
Hang on, he's not dead.
He growls and moves towards you.
I say, hold on, Noel. Like,
he's
definitely not undead based on the way he's moving.
Nevertheless, he just he grabs your collar and picks you up at this point. Or at least tries to.
He picks me up?
He tries to.
Bugbears are pretty damn big, actually.
They're 9 foot tall.
Yes.
Yeah.
Very smart, though.
A really big basketball player.
He just growls at you. He then drops you. Not the one.
Oh, he's damn intelligent. Bugbear.
How many people are in this darn... Balin at this point just sighs because he's wearing my... Oh. How many people are in this darn monastery anyway?
What are you doing here, Boris?
I couldn't count about 9.
I'm so confused about what side
I
he's on.
I asked Boris, like, what... He,
you sure he's not them? Not an elf scam.
What? Huh? I don't mean...
Well,
what?
If the area outside is clear enough for another to sneak through, we can sneak out. Grawl, would you mind? He just gestures to his wizard friend. Grawl just shrugs, picks him up, and they begin making their way out.
So the wizard's friends with the bugbear.
God,
he was their fourth member. He got a bit wounded by the zombies. He's a bit wounded. Well, thanks, friends. If we ever... We'll catch you another time, I'm sure. They leave back down the corridor and leave the six of you alone.
Introductions, maybe?
I'm just here so I don't get fined.
I'm going to shoot him in the leg. I kid.
Remember what I said about just taking your first action and rolling with it?
Yes.
Be glad I don't do that often.
I didn't say who!
I'd be glad I don't take that literally too often, even though I promise I would. And always promise I will. Carry on.
What are you doing here?
See, he used to be an adventurer until I shot him in the knee.
I hate you.
That was a very bad joke.
I wish
everybody
it's
make
sneakers.
A will save.
Okay.
No, you don't have to, but...
I would make the will save.
Fair enough.
To stop myself from punching him.
Nobody can stop you punching him.
The 9. I just look at it with disgust and just make a sigh. And punch the wall behind me. Slightly.
Anyway, a middle-aged human of above average weight with brain hair has walked in.
Above average, I'm 100 pounds more than my ideal weight.
I was being friendly.
I've eaten 3 people the same size as me.
With ranger sauce.
Oh, obviously.
Yeah.
That just sounds suggestive, Anna. You never know with these bloody elves and rangers.
How do I get rid of chat avatars? Because they're giant.
Yeah, it's in the settings, the cog at the top right.
Yeah. It's not going away.
You have to turn it to display the display setting. Not the don't show me people's video and voice stuff. The
Oh, nothing.
And yeah.
Avatar size.
Nothing names only.
Video player avatar size has to be turned to names only.
Okay.
You can put it down to names only. Video player avatar.
Somebody asked me, what am I doing here?
Yes.
Okay.
A very short gnome.
To be honest, I got lost. I got lost in the forest. I've eaten a lot of mushrooms, and I recently saw a dragon, so I'm hallucinating right now, and I don't know why I'm here. Nice to meet you. My name's Boris.
I think we can trust him completely. Welcome.
That was a very fast...
You can't trust anybody else in the party. How did you get this?
Well, to be honest, a stranger and an elf.
Well, to be honest... I'm the person I trust most in the world right now, so I trust me.
I make a quiet comment about...
Have you also heard about the...
No, he's human, actually.
The legend of the sword?
Oh, never mind, then. We can't.
I make a quiet comment about not a goddamn Navarat ranger.
Dylan, did you just ask me that?
Yeah, I was saying, have you heard about the legend of the sword? That seems to be what everyone's coming here for at the moment.
I'm sorry.
Why are you asking the people that came with you if they know about the legend of the sword?
So I'm not asking Boris if he knows.
I don't know about you guys, but I'm
sorry. I'm sorry, but I don't appreciate you using sexual innuendos on me like that. I'm not into that, man.
I go to Boris and say,
your pants are awful tight if you're wearing it.
I go to Boris that. I'm sorry about my gnome friend here, about his sexual innuendos. We are a group of adventurers seeking a sword of some value.
Swords.
I'm also sorry, I would also recommend you not to offer Snoopus any wrong build or targets, because he will most likely hit you in the leg.
I'm just saying, if we find some sort of magic that sends us back in time, you're getting eaten by a slime.
And guess what his downtime is going to be spent doing?
I ate a slime once. It was disgusting.
Well, I suppose he'd be useful if these dead ends are really something to worry about.
Yeah, they could be eating him instead of us. He's got enough meat on them bones to cover two of us.
I mean, you said you're not really doing anything at the moment, just tripping around the forest. You can make some decent coin if you come along with us. That's what's driving you in life.
Well,
I'm curious how you're going to play this, actually. Go around.
Well, you see, I'm a popular guy, as you can tell. I've got lots of offers. Why should I join you?
I won't.
Well, it might guarantee you get out of here alive.
Not that important. You got any food?
Yes, we have a lot of...
No, we don't, you...
You have no food?
I was making a rat kebab.
I go to Snoopus and say...
You can make rat kebabs?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm in. Hi, guys. I love you all.
And thus the party contract says we will pay Boris in their rat kebabs.
And regarding your comment on my pants, these used to fit me, and then I ate something. Many things.
No, you ate someone, friend.
Once you've ate four of them, they're no longer people to you.
I think the truth is, Hungry Red Dragon is hungry. Yeah. Boris kept eating all his food.
I think there's a secret here. There is a class in D&D, and I do have one of the manuals, which allows for dragon PCs.
Oh, just saying. Dragons.
No, actually, full dragon PCs.
They have that now?
Yes.
They've had that in 3.5. It's actually in the 25th anniversary version of Dragon, which I do own somewhere. But they have the ability to play any of the metallic dragons.
Boris should make a list.
So Boris could be a red dragon. They do know polymorph.
Oops. I go to our wizard. I think Boris should try and make a Western chat to see if he heard what Marin said to Snoopus.
Snoopus is like right next to me.
It doesn't matter. It's all there and obvious whether he heard it or not.
I'm just going to.
What chance is it?
You know what? I will do that because I have a 7 listen.
Go for it.
I am going to flap my arms a little.
Fair enough. Carry on. This is what we come to adventure for. Yeah, you hear that. This is what we come to adventure for.
What's
people
that?
Faffing around
What's
the room.
That? You're going to feed me dragon? Hell yeah. Oh, you guys are the best!
No,
I've never had dragon before.
Oh, yeah, I think you'll like it.
I go to Boris. Does he have, like, any antidotes to, like, poisons, maybe?
Dude, if I had antidotes, I wouldn't be tripping balls right now. Why would... Come on, use your head.
I think
so is it my action turn?
By the way, I'm probably giving you some roleplay experience because you're actually playing that quite well. I just had a quick check on something, but yes.
Yeah,
Don't worry.
Carry on. Explain to him or quickly or what?
If you want to. And
roleplaying, it really depends on the GM, but if you roleplay a character continuously and keep it for the campaign, normally the GM will just give you experience doing it.
Woo!
But there's got to be a reason, and I do kind of see a reason why you might be playing it that way. But carry on.
Yeah, I'm playing it that way because of how... Jesus.
Yeah, exactly. Carry on.
So,
they don't call me Thunderman for nothing, you know? That's not my second name.
Is there actually anything in this room of value?
A couple of low benches. There is a small faded altar to Paylor. Basically wooden frame altar with a cloth on it. That's kind
just
of
basically a
there,
small
there might be a few small wooden religious artifacts, but nothing really majorly valuable here.
Can I desecrate the altar?
You wish to desecrate an altar to Paylor? Go for it.
In front of several clerics.
In front of two clerics, yes. Go for it. Go on. What do I care?
Admittedly, I don't worship Paylor, but...
I'm going to kick the altar a little bit.
Can I quickly attempt to stop him from doing
Make
something?
A strength check.
Who, me or Snoopy?
Snoopy.
Are you trying to determine when the Snooper Snow breaks his foot?
No, actually. Okay, the altar doesn't move. And yes, you do hurt your foot in the process.
Hey, don't touch my god's altar!
I hop around the room on a single foot.
nobody disrespects Biggin the gluten.
Snoopy, can I have a spot check from you as well?
Yeah, sure, give me just a moment.
I'm right by him, shouldn't I make a spot check as well?
No, get out.
Get out!
Keep having to check what I gotta roll.
D20.
That's why the macros are really good.
The macros are helpful.
I just make a macro.
It's in the settings.
It's in the settings, but you can basically set up your default role. So I got a D20 set up here, which automatically goes to GM, which is important for me because I don't want you to know what they are half the time.
What was the macro? I can't see the macros.
You have to make
it
in the
end. I'll go through it later.
Right. Yeah, I'm making them during off.
By the way, yes, hurt foot. Nothing really changes. You've knocked a couple of the wooden small discs of Paylor if you're falling off of the altar, but other than that, yeah.
I only have one tear in my eye.
And
one.
You said
one?
Just the one. That's how hardcore I am. I only have a single tear.
As you kick the altar of a major god.
Yes.
Go for it.
How do you send PMs in here?
/ W and
you
then
you could use Skype, actually, in all honesty, but yes.
Let me test something. I think I remember.
It's W for whisper.
Yep, whisper.
Okay, thank you.
So / W and then the message.
Works the same as it does on Twitch, actually.
It's become D&D paranoia.
It's always D&D whisper. Paranoia.
Well, don't forget Roll 20 supports more games than D&D.
Yeah, I did at one stage set up a group at this point.
Okay, that went wrong.
Can I go out? Can we actually start making our way outside the room, guys, and see where these undeadums are, maybe?
Okay, you lead.
Undeadums? Oh, I hate undeadums. They have no meat on any of their bones.
What do you know about undeadums?
They're undeads, right?
Yeah, but what do you know about, like, aging by 30 years, maybe?
I know.
Nothing. I just don't like them.
Plans are being made.
I have a I have a feat called First Favorite Enemy Undead, so I have to hate undead.
Let's move on, shall we?
Go on, Snoopers.
No, you can't.
I've got the bow, you shadow sneaking dick waffle.
Did you just insult the GM, sir? I'm afraid that gives me the Hackmaster GM Smackdown table role.
No, I was talking to Hawkins.
He called him a pig waffle as a joke, I think.
Yeah.
Well, before we leave this room, I want to cast Detect Undead within 60 feet. Because supposedly there's undead around here hungry for people.
Okay, bear with.
No, that's just Boris.
Oh my god, you can have macros in the bar. That's so good.
Yes, you can. You just click a button and it rolls for you. That's what I mean.
What?
It's so
Where
helpful.
The fuck is it? What is this?
All right, click on the cog, and then at the very top says macros.
And then click add, and then give it a name.
Dex, strength, con.
And then type your slash roll, whatever that you would normally run in.
Oh,
in
god.
Okay. Let me just check something.
My spot is...
You get two impressions within 60 feet.
Oh, that does
not... Okay.
With the top of the map currently being north, in terms of where I'm showing in directions, there is a...
okay, that works.
There are undead within 60 feet to the rough northeast.
Okay.
There's also an undead to the west and also beneath you.
So both sides.
So either direction, they're both at sort of the extreme edges, so about 60 feet away.
Mm-hmm.
And so you can't just judge numbers, but you get the impression it's not more than a few at that range.
Okay.
And that's your cast of undead.
Detect undead.
Detect undead.
Okay. And that might be just be the beginnings of camps of them. The fringes.
By the way, you've now gained that knowledge as you've cast a spell. You won't notice her doing some mystic chanting or whatever it is to actually cast that spell. I didn't look that up.
Move away. I know about these fear-mongering people.
Well, I'm detecting undead approximately 60 feet to the north and also to the southwest of us.
Would I recognize the ritual, considering I'm also a cleric of the north?
Spellcraft.
Would we actually know which way is north and which way is south?
Because the other thing is, they're not exactly the same for each religion either, so it is...
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I'll give this to you for free, actually. She casts Detect Undead.
Would we actually know which way is north and which way is south?
As I said, I referred to it on the map so she could point. I said, assuming up on the map is north.
Okay.
I said that before I explained where it was in relation.
Forgot.
I did.
I forgot, sorry. Just wanted to make sure.
It's not actually north, but in fact, actually, your rangers, I think, can already know where north is, but still.
Based on my current experience of Boris, I wouldn't expect him to know where anywhere was.
Yes. Yes.
Sorry, what? I was zoned out. Where are we?
His directional sense probably points to the nearest tavern.
We both share that.
4 miles south-southwest.
I've got booze in my bag.
Sorry, what? Someone say booze? Hello?
Oh, I didn't say boots.
15 feet northeast.
He said boots. He has boots in his bag.
Oh, never mind. I'm bald again.
Boris casts detect boots.
I propose that we actually leave the altar and start exploring the rest of the camp.
I would, but it's too much fun to mock Boris.
Indeed. Maromwen, can I have a spot check from you?
Sure.
Oh,
okay.
Baron.
So back where you were, actually, for the spot check, actually, but no worries. Yeah. No, it doesn't matter. You just decided to shift a bit.
I want to feel along the walls for any hidden places.
That is fine.
Oh, God.
You're fairly certain there's going to be no hidden places along any of the four walls, because you've seen what's beyond the other side of them. The library and also the free areas.
What were you doing? What check?
That was
you
want
to do a
spot check.
What about the floors? Yeah, I was thinking that.
Are you saying this? Are you saying this out loud or to the shadow?
That you want to say out loud. Both. He's just like,
you're just happy that somebody has spent longer than eight hours in a room, and you've gone into it and spent another hour in the room. That there must be something in this room. Especially as just to double this up. Especially as I do not have this as one of my preset maps.
Did someone say they wanted me to search? I'm very good at searching things. I can find anything, especially food. Oh, crumbs. I love crumbs.
So, should we get going then? Or are we spending another 8 hours in here?
You could rest for the night.
So, did I spot anything?
No.
With my 16?
No. Nope.
I doubt we're overly tired, per se, since we actually rested not that long ago.
Well, I'm
actually less than half an hour ago.
Yeah,
I'm high, so I don't care.
I've not had a touch to drink in 24 hours.
You would have eaten when you rested.
Well, why would you expect so long? Well,
that's another matter entirely.
My booze is with the horse.
Which Boris found.
I
want to
look around. How much got left?
I want to look around.
How many horses are left?
I want to look around the altar for any indications of unusual things.
It's a wooden altar on whatever. Yeah, go. Make a search check.
Would it be spot? Oh, no, search.
Search.
Okay, that's good.
You're actually searching for things, so.
So, d20 plus my 3.
Search.
I'm heartbroken.
No. You don't find anything on that roll.
Bah.
I offered to search. I do have a plus 7. Too late now, guys. Then. Whatever.
Wouldn't do it then, you son of a bitch.
Okay.
Gods.
I'll use my macro. Play that spot.
Well, it's still rather saying 20. I'll just change a different modifier on this, but...
Boom.
Okay, you don't find anything either other than the same basic wooden amulets for Paylor. None of which seem significant or even still intact.
I got an 18. There's probably nothing here.
I'm going to pray to Elona.
Oh, God.
Off you go.
I get on my knees, pray to the mighty Elona.
That's not the traditional method of praying to her, by the way.
But I'm inside.
Praying for your boobs to come in.
Yeah.
Woo!
I don't have a gender. I'm no gendered.
Yes.
Are you sure?
Let me just see what else you have. Actually, you did have a gender. You do have a gender listed. You don't have a weight listed. Other than stop asking.
I think he's sensitive about the beer belly.
Yeah.
Clearly.
See, I'm actually a Ken, I'm like a Ken doll.
Nothing down there but a pair of
your
plastic underpants and a trademark.
Yeah.
Your avatar looks busty though.
So, 31 minutes into the recording, what are you going to do?
Leave the room.
All right, you've left the room.
Yeah, I've got to hasten to point out there was another section that we knew clearly existed that we haven't been into. Yeah.
There's quite a lot of it, sections, actually. But
I'm going to follow.
Yeah, but we've seen the entranceway to it. We just never went that way.
No, we didn't. I'm going to go full sheep mode and follow everyone else.
Okay, so where are you heading back to?
We're going back through into the corridor, I would assume. The corridor where I found the secret passage originally. There was a door at the other end, was there not?
Yeah, but don't we want...
There were two doors, actually.
These three doors here.
We went through all the doors in there.
Nope, because when you first entered right at the start of this, it was a long corridor into the room with the three statues.
Yeah.
Then you went into the T-shaped corridor, effectively teeing it off. Yeah. You went to the left-hand door because it had the library attachment. Then you fought the rats. There was two doors over to the right, a double door leading back and also a single door to the right. It's the room with the mirror, which you were a bit confused by.
I have a feeling that mirror is central to everything.
So do I. But I don't want to smash it.
So let me just actually revise things here, because I can actually draw it out on this. Depending on which layer I put these on. Okay. So with the library positioned where it is, we had a draw shape. See if we can get the number of rooms right.
Surprise call at sorting out funeral arrangements and stuff.
No worries, sir.
I've done it. My turn order's in the wrong place. Bear with. One of the problems with having to record this in a window is I'm using a much smaller screen than I should really be doing for this.
All right. Did you guys go on and do stuff, or are you just waiting?
We'd literally just left the room.
Right.
Yeah.
Yep. They've literally just left the
just
room.
Just left the room. Yes. You haven't missed much.
No, you really haven't.
We mostly just mocked Boris.
Yeah. No. Yeah. I didn't realize. I wasn't expecting it at all.
So this is the square chamber that you already know. You know there's a corridor here as well, which leads to the This is the secret door which led to the office,
yeah,
as you know about. And bear with. There are a single door there. Oop, there, rather. And a double door here.
Nice.
There, and the mirror is here. So, you're now in that corridor.
We weren't talking about the mirror yet, did we?
In this corridor?
Yeah. Yes, if you've gone back there. Which is what I think you were saying.
Through the library.
If not, then ignore this whole drawing and we'll go back.
I'm following Marigin.
Sounds like a sensible
idea. Marigin's in the secret
sensible
passage.
Idea.
No, I'm not in the secret passage.
I know. Just sniff his drag myself into it, though.
Right. Yeah. So you're now back into this corridor.
You're going to be reading, Ranger.
You'll see the double door, which basically goes, bear with.
Yeah. Is this the double door?
The double door here, and the corridor which eventually leads to the entrance, way that way.
Yeah, what I was trying to suggest is we go this way.
Yeah,
I say we should go that way.
Here.
Okay, which door are you going to go through, the single or the double?
Yeah, the single, isn't it? The one on the far end of the hall?
Yeah, the far end is a single, this is a double.
Yeah, single.
Yeah, I'll go through that one first.
Okay, bear with.
Is the door locked?
The door is not locked.
Check for straps.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm going to check for
straps. Unfortunately, I've run out of space with this, but the door isn't locked, it opens. It opens up into a...
you can also move stuff.
It opens up into a small kitchen, 20 by 30 feet.
Boris,
the sight that hits you immediately upon opening the door is you see two skeletons. On the ground, unmoving.
Oh. They're moving.
Unmoving.
Not moving, Snoopy. They are not moving.
You also see an additional door to the south, which leads, you'd guess, into the same room as the double door.
I go and cautiously grip my rapier and examine the skeletons.
They're very bony.
Why would you use a rapier to fight skeletons?
I don't have a
They are. They're in fact covered in a layer of dust. I'm suggesting they are ancient, basically. Well, ancient for any of you here who aren't elves or dwarves.
Stop poking your elders with the rapier.
I look at our... can any of our clerics sit, like, put them to rest, maybe? Just in case.
Inside?
In case
if you're asking if we can cast something to destroy undead, no, I don't think either of us have that yet.
In fact, I technically have a spell that can do that, but they're not actually moving around undead, so I'm not casting it.
Yeah, it's a waste of a spell until they do something.
There are two large cook pots in the room, but other than that, this room is fairly bare.
Just saying, I hear the marrow is really tasty.
There's ruins of shelves along the north wall, again, up wall, which I can't really show on this at the moment, but other than that, not a lot else here, seemingly.
Can I see what's in the cooking box?
I
was holding my nose.
At this point, some partially congealed substance at the bottom, but it doesn't look as if it's seen use in a number of years.
Do any people were trapped in here, or they just...
The door wasn't locked that you came in.
Mm-hmm.
They just rolled over and died?
My dad.
Possibly. They're both facing up, but so they might have been laid down here, but there's nothing else significant about the room that suggests why they might have been laid out here.
Are they like perhaps original monks? Monks are dumb, maybe.
Are there any like... No, you already said there's no numbers.
This is like an unknown order of monks, isn't it?
Yeah.
I know they're somewhat associated with Paylor, but it doesn't appear as if... you've only seen the one small temple that actually isn't what looks like a normal temple to Paylor.
It doesn't look like a normal temple?
You also know that it's 100 years ago since anybody worshipped Paylor actually was here.
You said imagine these are just the ancient monks.
Mm. You said there was another door here, right?
So, how bad is this great order again?
Sorry, I'm answering a question here. What did you ask?
I was just sort of asking the group, how bad is it in Desperate Orders?
Quite.
Yeah. It wouldn't do it.
Unless there's food on the altar.
You said there was another door in here, right, Shadow?
Yes, there's a single door, basic wooden one, which leads south on the way the map is.
Is it? I go to the door and chat for trap slash see if it's locked.
Search check.
Oh.
Which I assume I'm checking the traps before you go and pull open the door and see if it's...
What?
Alright, I'm going to open the door and then see if there's any traps on it.
Well, at least you won't need a search check after that point.
No, you might not have seen the trap activating.
13.
You don't see anything out of the ordinary with this door.
Is it what?
Yeah, as long as the offhand weapon is light, yes, for Zelly's question, actually, yes.
So I get -2 to both.
-2 to both, yeah. Actually, that works quite nicely for you then.
Is the door.
Yep.
Yeah.
The door is not locked. It opens up into a room. So I just need to go and grab each of you. I'm just going to move you. Oh, sorry. Actually, can I have a marching order for you at the door?
Okay, I'll go first like normal, I think.
So this is the door. I just want you to sort of, however the room is before then. So position yourselves against the door.
No, Snoopy, not through the door.
This
is the door down here.
Oh, have we gone into a different...
Yeah, no, just so we can space the characters out a bit better.
Yeah, because I'm just going to copy you over more or less as you are, so...
Two people going for a single door.
That's the resident, someone who's being stabbed and...
Well, that'll do.
Fireballed.
So Merwin's at the back then.
I move to the right, so Snoopy can not stab in the back or shoot me in the back.
I'll take up the rear.
If I would like to get shot by the very short gnome with the crossbow behind you.
Just if you keep saying that I'm going to shoot you in the back, eventually I am going to shoot you in the back.
Self-fulfilling prophecy.
It won't be good.
You have to accident, though.
But there's only so many times I could be accused of being a bastard with shooting people in the back, person.
I've just snapped, all right? Not my fault.
Alignment shifting is possible.
Okay, you've now been moved to there.
Oh yeah, God, you get like 15 points for doing that.
I checked for puddles.
All right, I will have a spot check from you, actually, then. Kind of inhibited by the fact you're behind Mr. Thunderman at this time. Hey,
you can throw your cloak under a puddle and make sure...
I was going into where the door was. Oh, there's a door there, right.
Yeah, that's the small door you've gone through. There are a load of thick cobwebs along the ceiling, thick layers of dust, and in fact lots of shuffling footprints which seem to be going all around this room and appear fairly recent.
Did you say along the ceiling?
Yes, he says along
cobwebs.
There have been cobwebs in various places a lot in the previous rooms, actually, as I think I described at the time.
I want to try and find...
Cobwebs are not unnatural for a room like this.
This just appears to be a standard dining room. There are various portraits
I'm more worried about
faded,
the
but they appear to be of individual people. Possibly the leaders of the monks here, you're not sure. There are a few bookcases along the edges. This might have just been a recreation dining room style thing by the look of it.
It's
the mess hall.
Are we in this room or not?
You're not at the moment. I've just positioned you just above it. But you can see where the door is, where Thunderman is.
I equipped my crossbow and load it just in case.
So paranoid about empty rooms.
I don't know why they're paranoid. They have no reason to be paranoid.
No, I'm more paranoid by the recent shuffling footsteps.
You see no puddles of water anywhere near the windows at the back. I know it's not really represented well, but there is a window at the back if you scroll down.
Okay. Dwarf is like...
It's high in the ceiling. It's high in the ceiling, but a bit bigger than the ones you've seen previously, letting a reasonable amount of illumination in. Though, obviously, it's now dusk, so there's very, very, very little of it now.
Anything under the tables?
You're searching under the that table, are you?
A bit far, yeah, but I'm looking under the table.
Okay. Make a reflex. Actually, hold on. Let me think about this a moment.
I would also like to do a room search.
Well, Hawkins is the one who's gone and looked under the table first, so we'll resolve that. What is the rest of you doing?
I would like,
Go on.
I would like to flap my wings angrily.
Is You're going to flap your wings angrily!
I asked, is this a trap?
I don't know yet.
Is what happened to you?
Who are you talking to?
Because I get
the GM!
Sense. Yes. I get trap sense, so...
I'm gonna jump on top of the table to save my situation.
So your first action is jump onto the table. Okay, Snoopy is flapping his wings angrily,
get aerial view
up
of
some
the
dust.
Room. I can't see over the tables otherwise.
I would like to search the entire room. This is a dining room.
Is
there
this
could
a
be food in here.
Yes, those look like bookshelves. Also.
Those are bookshelves. They're faded and crumbling, but they are bookshelves.
Don't we do my reflex
I'm
gonna
look at the books and see if there's anything of interest here.
I agree with Merwin's idea. I'm going to take a quick look at this one.
As you look under the table, you are confronted by this.
Oh, ah! Jesus!
Knew it! I wasn't going to say anything, but I was like, yeah, it's going to be spiders.
Is it a frog spider?
Yeah.
It's under the table, by the way, at this point. But
do I get a don't we make a reflex roll, I'm guessing?
No, it's not a reflex roll. You've just basically gone over there.
You know,
you're surprised. It's attacked. I'll need initiative rolls in a moment, but
I just said
it's the GM, sir.
Personally, initiative actually.
I'm going to do initiative in a moment, but for the moment.
Oh, sorry, I should have made it one of the macros.
Right. Fair enough. Let me just do my thing here.
Guys, let's be honest. Did we really? We all knew it was going to be a fucking giant spider, right?
Yeah, kind
of. I thought it was a bit puppy.
we should really check under the other tables just
clearly. It was going to be a Vorpal bunny.
I hope it's going to get a surprise attack.
What's your flat footed armor class?
Mine?
Yes, Hawkins.
12.
Okay, you'll hit. So that is a good old d4.
You got bitch
and a fortitude
size,
save.
That's just a D20 plus.
Plus your fortitude. Yeah, so.
12.
You fail?
You have a fortitude of 1?
I've got a strength penalty at the moment due to poison.
Strength doesn't affect fortitude, it's constitution. However, speaking of strength penalty, that's gone down another 3.
Very shortly, he's going to lose the ability to move.
2 separate strength poisons.
No one got a way to cure this.
Nope. Well, you know, I swear he
I'm
said,
a cleric,
make
not
it
enough.
Food!
BRB!
That's
so,
someone,
can I have initiative from everybody now that the surprise round's over?
Yeah.
Yes, I shall click my handy-dandy button.
Uh-huh. Look, my buttons make me roll a 16. I'm happy with that. Make that 18.
Sleep is on 17.
Oh, no, I have to...
Is this just a poison, or is it...
This is poison.
Okay.
It will eventually go away.
It will go away if you rest, but there will be a second kicker in about a minute, so.
Yeah, but name my luck, I'll just save that.
Well, I already know what I'm doing 13. For my action.
I know what I'm doing 13? For my action.
It's a handy dandy action that has saved me the crew this entire time.
Morris and
Merwin
again gets a feature of rolling crits and 19s for initiative.
Jesus.
And
I'm just awesome. The awesome elf.
The elf of awesome, indeed.
Yay!
Who thinks she's a ranger even though she's a cleric?
I know.
Oh, sorry, you thought you were a druid, weren't you?
I have a short-term memory. So I forget what I am sometimes.
I have returned.
It's your initiative, sir. Well, roll for initiative, then we'll work out whether it's your initiative or not.
Or maybe I have a split personality. One of me is a ranger and the other is a cleric.
Okie coke.
Handy dandy initiative modifiers, go!
Boom!
Right.
Oh, wow. We did good.
Sword ascending. Oh, nope. Sword descending.
What's Okie coke, I want to know? I mean, in Liverpool, did they run out of, like, actual Coca-Cola's to steal and just stole some right. dodgy off-brand?
Remwin, yep. You're out first.
There are actually quite a few dodgy off-brands around here.
Well, there are everywhere, but most people don't nick it.
Yeah, it's Hawkins, not very nice.
Beside you, proud in pain, and you see a spider has just tried to take a chunk out of his leg.
Hey!
Ow.
So, I'm going to guess this isn't a friendly spider.
Nope.
You probably... Well, I might be just surprised. You could try reasoning with it in your round, but Meringwin goes
first. I kind of have to ask, have you ever met a friendly spider?
No. Spiders are friendly.
May I ask how
you could
exactly...
be a passive spider, never friendly.
How exactly?
How exactly do I use wild empathy? I realize I probably can't use it on this guy, but...
I'll have to look it up, but it's basically allows you to use, I forget what check it is, handle animal things, so I'll look it up.
I'm not actually sure.
For the moment, Graham went.
Sure, you can use
it. I'm going to produce flame and throw it at the, spider.
Okay, so you're casting, produce flame, make your ranged touch attack then.
Throwing fire at things that are flammable again.
Well, no, she only sets on fire what she wants.
Yeah. Well, I can either touch something...
The produce flame does have that stated. It doesn't burn or anything she doesn't wish it to.
Yeah. So, throw an attack costs 1 minute duration.
Yeah, each attack costs you a minute of a duration, but the flame actually lasts for 3 minutes.
A d6 plus damage... Well, a d6 damage plus one per level. I'm level 3, right?
Yeah, so it'll do d6 plus 3 damage, but... Okay. Yep, range touch attacks. You'll have to make a d20 roll.
Any modifier on my
range? Whatever your range, whatever your normal range is.
Ranged.
It should be right at the start of your character sheet.
Okay.
Just above your weapon listings.
I'm just looking at
six. So D20 plus six.
Yep.
I'd like to do these diplomacy checks.
And then a D6.
Ranger level, charisma modifier, D20. To improve the attitude of animals. It's basically a diplomacy check for animals. with your ranger level as a bonus.
So you're trying to make a friendly spider.
Indeed. In the meantime, it's
I could do.
In the meantime, you burn it slightly.
It
recoils back under the table a little.
Diplomacying after somebody tried to set fire to it.
Yes.
Boris, you're up second.
Well,
I'm not very diplomatic.
Can I have a spot check from you before your turn starts?
Sure.
Okay, carry on.
I got a
you
one.
You don't see it.
I hope this is as big as they get.
It's going
to
be
Would I even be able to attack this thing since it's under the table?
You know it's under the table, but you can't see it currently.
You've now made extra.
How much is Hammond a heavy guy?
No, but you're not flipping the table.
I'm considering flipping the table.
Not with me on it.
Can I flip the table?
If you launch him far enough, his ring of feather fall will save him.
Strength check.
Damn it!
No, that's not going to be enough to flip the table.
Yeah, I weigh 40 pounds.
Okay, so that's your action. You've attempted to flip the table, haven't succeeded. You can still move if you wish, I suppose.
So, in fact, Boris has given himself a small hernia.
stand...
He's got a heavy gnome preventing him from flipping it.
I'll stand here because Snoopus is a very...
You can now see the spider from there.
Well, in fairness, considering that Boris's strength is probably about average.
Actually, Boris's strength is reasonably good.
So I'm 15. Going to do... Oh, wait, is it noise right
It's Hemet's turn.
Hemet's, yeah.
You notice his disturbance underneath him. Can I have a spot check from you?
Yep.
Do the turn order, sir.
Hey, it doesn't work properly, does it?
Yeah, that's...
It keeps disappearing.
Oh. Mine's there at least, so...
Mine's not there. It just says large spider.
Yeah, me too.
I have a feeling that there must be something you're missing that's causing
there it. There probably is something I'm doing wrong for this, in all honesty, because I'm copying and pasting spot tokens check. Over to get them there.
Beating.
I'll look up for you.
Thanks. Okay, you spot the second large spider underneath the third table.
I expected that, Dan.
Yes. Maybe you want to,
you
like,
spot him under the third table.
Announce that they're
still... Can I actually target him from here?
You can see him just about, yeah, so...
Can I throw a Melf's Acid Arrow at him?
Very well, go for Melf's Acid Arrow.
Okay.
It's a ranged touch deck, isn't it?
I assume so. Yeah, it's definitely in range. It's like 400 feet.
I mean, it's a ranged touch deck.
Yeah, to roll.
It's not an automatic hit, is it?
I would assume not for this spell, because it's not like a target one. It's a attack spell, so... It's plus 3 for my range.
Yeah, ranged touch attack. Make it then.
I'm disappointed, actually, that nobody's cast Magic Missile. It doesn't feel like D&D without Magic
Missile.
He
can't learn Magic Missile. He's got that as his banned school.
Whoops, I messed up. I messed up my macro.
Shadow, are all the names except for the spider grayed out to you?
Sorry?
On the turn tracker, are all the names grayed out except for the spider?
No.
Oh.
I can see all the names on the turn tracker because I've added the token.
Yeah, can you see them, but are they slightly grayed out?
Not at all, actually.
Never mind then, continue.
I don't see them at all. So, it's okay though.
Let me see if I've actually cast enables removal turns starting episode. There doesn't seem to be any options for me to just show people, but there normally is for this sort of thing.
Is everyone's name in the same order down at the bottom of the page? Does everyone see Shadow, Bird, Marigen, Snoopy, Hemet, Zelly?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, I guess we could use that as just a role.
No, it's fine. Don't worry. I have the order here. It's not as if it doesn't exist. I can use it, and I could track it with paper, even if I couldn't. So,
well, as long as you have it.
Yeah. So, Hemet, make your attack roll.
I have. I see my miss.
Yes, you do. So you missed. You want to move?
Am I safer above or under, or like to the side of the table? Because it's probably could just climb around.
Yeah, but I have to.
I probably just reach out and grab you too.
Remember that it's an animal. Probably just going to attack the closest thing.
Well, if someone wants to flip the tail, I better get off of it.
Probably best. Although I don't think.
One,
it's...
two, three, four is how far I can move.
Okay. Snoopus!
I'm going to scream and put 2 arrows into it.
Okay, go for it.
We have to probably sleep to get rid of your poison anyway, so I don't mind spending my spells.
Let's see. I don't take the thingy. Point blank, so plus one. Is that the full plus 9?
You're taking 2 shots, so plus 7 each, isn't it? But yeah.
You haven't put the other spider on the map yet?
Oh, yeah.
No, I haven't for the moment.
Yeah, because we haven't.
Because you haven't announced that it's there and it hasn't moved either.
So here comes the natural ones.
Alert. Spider underneath the third table.
2. So close, but no.
Second one hits.
And my damage is 1d8 plus
8. I probably don't have a mecha for that. That's your normal damage.
D8 plus 2.
Okay. You hit it, but it doesn't seem to bother it too much as it's... continues trying to attack Hawkins.
What does everyone hate there?
Because you're there and you surprised it.
Okay. It surprised me. Like, can't we just, like, leave it there?
Mutual surprise, okay?
Mutual surprise. Who's to
Hawkins!
If I take a shot at it with my crossbow, would I discount as point blank?
Yes, but it would also provide an attack of opportunity because you're within its attack range.
Okay. I attack it with my rapier then.
Oh.
Did you have your crossbow drawn?
No, I don't. Did I?
I don't think
you did.
You
must
have,
if you're about to fire it.
No, I don't think it is.
Okay, well, in any case, you weren't using your crossbow in any case. But if you were, that would spend the whole round basically.
Yeah, I was just wondering.
But still, rake your attack then. See if he's learned from his ability to deal with rats.
Like, what? Oh, I have no attack bonus in that. Okay, it's just a base d20.
Of course, he hasn't learned.
How do you... Oh, yeah, because your strength has gone down another 2 points, hasn't it? So
14.
So, hold on. Your temp score is actually 6, then.
Yep.
which I'm now putting on there. So yeah, negative zero.
Oh my god. Okay.
I was just checking all that, but yes. I was editing it on the sheet myself.
So yep. At this point, he weakly flails at the thing.
Stop it.
He does actually hit it, though.
What?
You poked it?
I hit it?
You actually do hit it.
On...
It's not exactly an armored monstrosity. It's a spider.
But it's a big-ass spider.
Oh.
Minus your new strength penalty.
That's from a rapier, right?
So that's minus two, actually, so that's two damage.
Yeah,
and they do have ectoskeletons.
Because you're feeling weak.
It's karma for knocking me out.
Can I take a 5-step? 5-foot step?
Yes, you're allowed to take a 5-foot step without any penalties.
I take a 5-foot step backwards.
That isn't it moving, that's just where it has to be because of all the attacking we've actually been doing. Alright. Warwick. Spot check.
Okay.
Oh, no.
No, you don't spot the spider on the table. What are you doing?
I don't spot the one here, or I don't spot the one over here.
You don't spot the one that hasn't been put on the map yet.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I'd be
with the table, sir.
I could do it. It's about the only thing I could do. I can't get in range otherwise.
Yeah.
I say you should cleave the table.
Cleave doesn't work like that.
You could destroy two tables at once with cleave, but
potentially I could if I stood there, hit one and destroyed it, then I'd get a chance to cleave on the other one as well.
So we're gonna attempt to flip the table.
I'm curious as to how strong the table would be against attacks. Actually,
this is where the handful comes in helpful. It's normally used for calculating hit points of buildings. You'd be surprised how often it's needed. But tables, I think, are listed in the book somewhere.
The table has
someone else
points.
Is trying to hit the table.
I'm fairly sure tables, there's nothing like a D-handful type score.
No.
Probably
but that's
a little less defensive than the door was for me.
All you did was burn it, and unfortunately the cone caused it to go backwards. But anyway, are you attacking the table or are you flipping it?
Burned my ass.
It looks fairly sturdy, in all honesty. It's a sturdy dinner table, which, while it's aged, it still is.
Yeah,
it would have seen lots of people.
I should flip it.
Strength check, then.
A strength check for me would not be that bad, so.
20 plus whatever your bonus is.
Yeah, 3. Oop.
By the way, Shadow, I did.
The table flips!
Yeah, pretty good.
Shadow.
The
future reference, I did declare my dodge on the war spider.
We haven't stated that, so no, you
I
haven't
I did
yet.
Say right at the start.
I don't care. Right, the table is now effectively there, and it's flipped up, and has basically blocked off the spider. We've now we'll be shuffling backwards, because it's his turn next.
Yeah, I presume he's going to shuffle towards me, because I'm the nearest thing it can reach.
It's a spider. Why does it care? It can just climb over it.
Yes, it can.
Spiders still tend to just run away from things if they suddenly move in front of them.
That's what I've been hoping for, that he'll just run away. Spiders are creatures of logic. Why would it fight
it's
five
a
people?
Giant spider.
Six people.
Right.
No, it's a large spider.
Get it right,
two,
bro.
Two, three.
Yeah.
Shuffle. Bite.
Hey.
It's a large spider who's using logic and it's still attacking us. Why do you think that is?
Because
we just...
What's your armor class?
My armor class is 17.
Yeah, he doesn't hit you at all. Climbs over the top and attacks Mr. Boris. In fact, he more or less just steps over it, actually, because he's that big, but yes.
Jesus.
Oh, so it's still... I thought I got attacked.
My armor class was 17.
He misses as well.
I hasten to point out, on the scale of things, that's a 10-foot wide table.
Yeah,
I'm aware, but it's also a large target, so it is actually a 10-foot tall spider.
It's
a small thing. It was crouched down underneath the table when it heard scurrying coming towards it. But
looks like it's at least an 8-foot spider in comparison to the table.
I know, but that's just the model I got.
Sizes are not relative. This is like, except, it's except like on exams when it says not so, scale.
What we can accept is it's a big fucking spider.
Yeah,
it's a big spider. Not as big as they get, but big enough.
Mm. It's also not as lethal as they get. It's just a normal spider rather than, like, say, a salt spider or something.
Normal my ass.
Well, Vanna, it's your turn. The spider has climbed up on the table and gone to bite your colleague to the left. It's within strike range of you now.
Shadow, can I have it be, like, canon that I never block an attack, I always gracefully dodge it?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
I, like, pirouette out the way.
Bounces off of his belly.
Yeah, you never block, you just bounce, deflect. Yeah. Your iron tummy technique.
I kung fu panda it.
I want to cast bull strength on myself, so I gain 4 strength for a minute, and like, jab it with my staff.
Okay, I'm going to have to make a attack of opportunity against you.
For casting a spell, yeah.
Bear with. Okay, it misses, so your spell is cast.
Okay.
So you can put in temporary modifier, a temp score for you as 18. Okay. So now I effectively got 18 strength.
Okay. And let me see my spell.
This further affects all of your modifiers and things and whatever else, and that lasts for 10 rounds. Well, actually, 10 rounds, I think.
Okay, so I do a d20 plus 18.
What?
Because I have 18 strength.
You have 18 strength, but that means your now modifier is plus 4, so you now do d6 plus 4 damage, and you have a plus 2 effective to hit modifier on both your current attack scores. So instead of a single attack of plus 5, you now have a single attack of plus 7.
Oh, okay, so a d20 plus 7.
And
a
d6 plus 4 damage for the next 10 rounds.
Okay.
But that's your turnover, so Boris, you're up.
Double attack!
Oh, you don't attack yet. That was your turn because you cast the spell.
Oh.
Yeah, you do one action and then move is your turn.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Or you just...
Oh, at least you didn't get the one.
Right. The good news is both your picks have hit.
Woo!
The bad news?
I don't think there is any bad news here.
No,
roll
ain't
damage.
No bad news. First weapon. Damn it.
Bad news is you rolled a 1.
Eh.
Second weapon.
Damn it.
Double 1.
Wow. Well, that's the bad news then.
That's still 7 damage.
Yeah, the creature recoils and falls back on the other side of the table.
At least he has chicken.
Spider legs.
Out of curiosity, to check something. If I was here, would my cleave potentially hit both?
Yes.
I think you know where you're moving.
Hemet, you're up next.
Okay. It's a ranged touch attack, and that's there, right? So if I miss, I could hit Warwick, right?
You'd have to
very unlikely.
Yeah.
And I'd probably be lenient in saying it just missed.
Okay, I'll try another mouse assassin there. The last one, I've got 2 readied. This is my last one.
You miss.
One of these days, I'll whistle.
Touch attacks are really easy to hit with, but miss.
Yes. I don't get any bonus for being a touch attack, do I? Just get standard range.
It's just a standard range bonus, so. Yeah. You mean there's melee touch attacks as well, which you could use if that's better, but either way.
I'm glad that I've been here for 1 second, and I'm already the most useful person here.
Well, yeah, you've got double pickaxe.
Woo!
Because, yes, this is a dual-wielding ranger with pickaxes.
Sorry, Warwick.
It's nice to know that if I hit with both, my minimum damage is still 7.
Snoopus.
I am going to gracefully run over here, then over here, then here. Then I'm going to shoot this spider bastard.
Which spider bastard?
Low-health spider bastard.
The low-health spider bastard?
How do you know it's not a spider bitch? Have you checked?
They're all bastards.
You could do knowledge nature to find this out.
I'll do that afterwards, they're dead.
Okay, roll attacks then. Oh, yeah, nice. I think that spider's dead. Roll damage for the sake of it, but yes. No, it's definitely dead.
Minus 12, sir.
It is definitely dead.
In that case, I just smite this one.
Spider. Right.
I cheer hurrah.
Organs.
Don't
cry.
No, I was about to say, don't the poison orchard say now, or is that next turn?
It's got a minute. Time. It's a minute between them. I'm sure it is. I'll have to read out later, but
no, okay.
So you've got a few rounds.
I equip my crossbow and load it.
Okay, so you've loaded your crossbow.
Yeah.
That'll be your round. Rick.
Smack.
Smack.
With the mace, yes.
Indeed.
Well, yep, it wasn't a crit, that's a solid hit. So,
that
damage.
Is a very solid hit.
Ouch.
That, Zelly, is why you don't get too impressed at your double pickaxe.
For some reason, it's not coming out with a darn thing. Bear with. Oh, I'll just have to do it that way around then. But it's not coming up with a little bars for me at the moment, which is annoying. Anyway. Carrying on. We now move to the large spider turn. And he goes for revenge! You said your armor was 17?
Yes.
It's critted you.
Oh. Wow.
That was revenge.
That is revenge.
So you made him mad.
The dice roller things. That's.
Does it confirm it though? Doesn't it?
It probably did confirm the crit.
14 damage.
I can take that just about.
And then your fortitude save from you.
Fortitude for me is quite good. So.
Wow.
Tonight is not the good night roll.
You've lost 5 points of strength temporarily due to poison.
Oh, for feck's sake.
You also fall down and drop your weapon at that much damage at once. So he's fallen prone.
I blame
Puffed
this.
Up Marinwen. Your turn.
I blame this on Orbi.
I can only move 5 steps, right?
Oh, I'm sorry for spotting the spider.
Steps. And you can't move diagonally.
Oh, I can't diagonal you. Okay.
You should be sorry. Jesus.
You should be able to get there.
All right, it's 4 steps diagonally for me to get to work. And I've got bull strength on me now. So I'm going to whack it with my staff and try to smack it against the bookshelves and see if I can knock it out.
Oh, she's going for spider punt.
Yeah.
Well, she is going at... Well, actually, no, she's now at... athlete level strength actually at 18, so yeah, not quite into the superhuman levels at this point, but still
she's only just slightly stronger than Warwick, but she is stronger than Warwick.
That's a hit. Roll damage.
6.
Okay, okay, it's still standing. Boris.
Well, I dive across this table.
Select. Okay, I'll need a climb check since you're doing that.
Want to be a jump check?
Oh, yeah, a jump check will do, actually.
This is why I went around it.
Boom!
Boom! He elegantly leaps over the table.
He's like a hawk. It's like
I jump.
I've
I
never seen a fake man so gracefully.
With a thud right here. And I double attack. Ah!
Go for it.
And I hit with my secondary. Oh, god damn it.
You're good. I mean, honestly, you're wielding pickaxes in a dungeon, and there is some penalty for that, apparently.
Don't you keep rolling once? Jesus.
He's still alive.
It's only a 1-4 chance.
Oh, is he not actually... Ah, that might be why. For some reason I managed to disconnect this guy. Doesn't matter, he'll be dead in a minute anyway. Right, Hemet.
I've got a risk of hitting people if I shoot with my crossbow, right?
Here's the thing where the spider now does a TPK.
It'd be surprising. Especially if Snoofus has got a chance to shoot it next turn, regardless of what happens.
What's my odds of shooting someone else when I shoot the spider?
Don't roll a one.
Yeah, if you roll a one.
There we go.
Actually, did you have your crossbow drawn? Because you were casting spells earlier.
How many hands do I need to cast a spell? Because light crossbow is one-handed.
All right, we'll let you off. I'll look into that later, but for now, I'll let you have it.
And all this, he's going to punish you later if this isn't true.
Well, I already have to punish him for his cat.
Eight.
Yeah, spider falls.
Dead.
He's dead.
Punishing him for cat is easy, though. He just suddenly explained that an infuriated cat pops out from underneath his little hat and claws the fuck out of his head.
Especially when he gets called an owl.
Oh,
are we still in combat?
No.
I'm going to look under the third table.
Oh, yeah.
I'm looking up.
I'm going to cure...
Other than normal-sized sort of spiders, you don't see anything else up there.
I've just realised I've made a mistake. I could have killed that spider by jumping onto it and squishing the spider.
Yes, you could have done.
That was 10 feet.
I'm good. Can we attempt to get the poison glands from the spider?
So what you're saying is that you're going to body slam it?
Yes.
Shut up.
There should be a ranger that takes that, right?
There we go.
The ranger should be the one to extract the poison gland.
That's what I'm asking, just in general.
I'm one of those.
We should probably rest to get rid of this poison on you lot.
Yes.
Oh, you guys are poisoned?
Yes, we are poisoned.
I'm the frontline fighter, and I took no damage. You guys suck.
I also did more damage in one hit than you did in basically three.
Yeah, but I have the highest max damage.
In theory.
In theory.
And he's doing the dance well.
Yes.
Well, you see,
he's doing Boris, the shuffle.
Boris, as a young lad, was raised by a stripper, so he's very good with tables.
And poles, I would imagine.
Oh, he loves poles.
And eight arms reaching out to him.
Well, hang on. Let's square dance! Come here. Oh, damn it. I double clicked. So you've now just got a ranger and a dwarf square dancing on a table because Shadow's not
because...
paying attention.
No, I am. I'm trying to read this. I'm just trying to find the thing here.
By the way, did we check the other table?
We're going to throw
up. Super Set was going to.
Yes.
He did, and he didn't find anything else under there.
Thank God.
I do a general room,
thank
sir.
All right, search check then.
I'm going to do it too.
Okay.
Jesus.
Did I find anything interesting in the bookshelf up by the door that came in?
I need a search roll for you as well, then.
Okay.
Do the camera search roll. I want to investigate the portraits, see if there's anything on them that's, like, you know, noticeable.
They're a bit too faded to get any information over them. They're vaguely mostly... They're mostly human.
Okay, I just wanted to have, like, get, like, a hint of, like, a peril or something.
Shadow, don't we make another fortitude save? Come on.
Yeah, I will need another fortitude save from you now.
He's going to fall over. He's got a resting here.
7 from me. Probably
17.
Huzzah, you resist the secondary effects of the poison.
I would like to look for loot.
I would like to rest.
Yeah,
Marishin, I'll need a check from you in a moment. Another fortitude set.
A fortitude. Okay.
Yep.
Let me see what... Let me set a macro up.
Is there any cool loots in here?
You're able to find something akin to a scroll with mysterious unknown writing on it.
Where I found it?
A quick check with Hemet suggests that it's arcane writing.
Okay, now I have a strange scroll.
Okay, you resist secondary effects of poison as well.
So it's probably just another magic spell, so I guess I'll take hold of that for now.
Oh, will you? Will you now?
Well, I'm the one who can identify it.
Will you now? How much gold are we talking here?
Hold on to it if you want, and you can suddenly learn how to spell, like, cast spells.
I bet
he's been looking over your shoulder all the time in case he wants to take a level of wizard later.
I'm going to give it to
Okay.
I came back and all I heard was I'm going to give it to Hemet.
Indeed. That's all you need to know about the conversation.
So, with the arcane scrolls, I need... Do I need identify to identify those, or can I just use read magic?
Read magic or read a scroll.
So I can ready that up when I'm going to sleep, right?
Yeah, it's a cantrip, so...
Yeah, okay. I'll, I got two scrolls technically at the moment, so I'll swap out my ghost sound. Actually, I don't need to swap that out. That's my free extra one for illusion. I guess I'll swap out my two dazes, I think, for two read magic. So I read both the scrolls.
Yeah, they're technically rewrite magic, but yeah, the same thing, really. Yeah.
I'm going to sleep on top of the table.
Okay. So you're resting up for the night. Is there anybody going to be keeping watch?
Boris will keep watch.
I'll keep watch.
Boris can keep watch. He's new here. Don't let
you watch. Are you happy with your current spell setup then? I thought you were going to change to your other one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I thought you were going to change to your other spell lineup.
So I have to take a nap to do that, right?
Yeah, because you have to change your spell list. So.
Okay. All right, yeah, I'll take a nap, and I'll let Boris keep an eye out.
Okay.
I still thought, does she have to only do it for 4 hours?
No, she still needs the 8 hours. I think she actually technically gets them at dawn. I'll have to look that up, but it will be dawn in about 8 hours, oddly.
But I'm going to nap in the corner against the bookshelf here, because that only leaves me two directions that I can be attacked from.
I'm going to sleep on top of the table, because there's probably, like, spider goo all over the floor and stuff.
And I want to be tall!
I'm going to move away from him. He's weird.
He's
trying to sleep near me. What is this?
I take up no checks. Room on this table. It's fine.
Yeah, there we
go. Can I have a spot check for whoever's keeping first watch?
Boris, what you said, right?
Is it me?
Spot and listen checks for whoever's keeping first watch.
I heard everything.
You did. There is, there's still a low chittering of rats and definitely some scraping underneath you. It's faint, but there's definitely something scraping underneath you.
Would I assume that that's just the rats?
Possibly, though for some reason you don't believe it is.
I would like... Mm-hmm. Underneath us. Can I... Is there any noticeable way to get beneath us from this room? Like any...
Nothing at all. You've not even seen a set of stairs in this entire place.
Can I, like, do a check on, like, the floor, even under the tables? Just to see if any of the tiles look suspicious or anything?
Yeah, okay, I suppose. You find a couple of loose tiles, but it only reveals the stone flooring underneath it.
Well, I've lost interest.
What have I missed?
I'm going to...
Instead,
I'm going to check Snoopy's bag, because they said they had food.
Okay, here we go.
Going
to get stabbed.
Well, I need to work it out.
To be honest, you probably wouldn't hear me. I have a +9 to move silently.
He does have about 8 days worth of rations.
I'll eat two of them.
Wait, oh, okay.
2 days.
What about a listen check?
All right, have a listen check then.
He's like a reverse hobbit.
Versus his move silently. He can still fail this. He can still fluff his move silently. Go on, move silently for Boris Thunderman.
That's the 26.
Oh, okay. No, not at all.
What have I missed?
You've missed PvP. Glorious, glorious PvP.
You know what? I'll eat one.
Yeah, we're just all sleeping at the moment.
To me.
Apart from Boris.
Okay, second watch.
Alright, when I'm finished, I say, that was a lovely snack.
Oh, Snoop's probably should have taken second watch because we need the two poison people to sleep and the two people spells to sleep.
Yeah, I'm a little health.
Sleepy's not going to help.
I'm going to hop AFK for a second.
Okay,
I'll
take the watch then.
Oh my god, I also have sleight of hand.
I'm going to wonder where my rations went.
Did I give you sleight of hand?
I do have sleight of hand.
You have the ability. Oh, it's just untrained ability, just a deck, basically. Yeah. But yeah, you very do. Right, spot and listen checks for you. And god darn it, there's moths here again.
First one was this and second spot. should have put them.
Okay. You get the impression of you get the impression of movements underneath the cracks of the doors to the north.
Oh god.
A slight shifting in the shadow, suggesting something's moving.
Ignore
oh shit. Who's close?
Am I sleeping behind the table?
You don't hear anything though, but this you just notice the slight darkening of shadows near the door, and then suddenly it moves away. Everybody's asleep other than Snoopers at this point.
Am I asleep behind the upturned table though?
You're sleeping there, yeah.
Okay.
Presumably it's been put
is that
back
table
down.
Still up? Is that table?
No, I'm presuming you put it back down. But
so I'm sleeping under the table.
Okay, I'm going to move here, and then I'm going to keep my bow and arrow pointed at the door.
I want to add, during my sleep, I accidentally get Snoopy slightly.
Actually, that's really good if you can do that. Yeah, awesome.
Yeah, I know, that's what I said earlier. That's what I should have put in my thingies. That which...
That's fine, we'll go through that later. Anyway, Snoopy?
Yeah, I've just moved there and now my bow and arrow pointed.
Okay.
I missed what you heard.
A minute goes by. He didn't hear anything, he spotted something. A minute goes by, another minute. Another minute.
Suddenly, I start snoring extremely loudly.
Yeah, I didn't hear it.
Deafeningly loudly.
I'm going to. I'm going to kick Boris in the ribs.
Okay. He definitely seems to dodge it as he turns over. Okay. Third watch. As it's approaching dawn.
Have I healed from my poison yet?
I'm still red.
You will in the morning!
I've rested for 4 hours. I don't need anymore.
Okay.
Whoever wakes up, just wakes up.
Everybody wakes up at this point and restores hit point. Those of you who had an interrupted rest.
Snoopy, you probably...
do I get a hit point?
No, you had 4 hours of interrupted rest rather than full eight.
Did
I thought as an elf, you get to have four.
Oh, actually, yeah, you do get to have four. Go on then.
Yeah.